Outside the house, the two boys were together all through their boyhood. Chambers was strong beyond his years, and a good fighter. Strong because he was coarsely fed and hard-worked about the house, and a good fighter because Tom furnished him plenty of practice on white boys whom he hated and was afraid of. Chambers was his constant bodyguard, to and from school. He was present on the playground at recess to protect his charge. He fought himself into such formidable reputation by and by that Tom could have changed clothes with him and ridden in peace, like Sir Kay in Lancelot's armor. He was good at games of skill, too. Tom staked him with marbles to play keeps with, and then took all the winnings away from him. In the winter season, Chambers was on hand in Tom's worn-out clothes with holy red mittens and holy shoes and pants holy at the knees and seat to drag a sled up the hill for Tom, warmly clad, to ride down on, but he never got a ride himself. He built snowmen and snow fortifications under Tom's directions. He was Tom's patient target when Tom wanted to do some snowballing, but the target couldn't fire back. Chambers carried Tom's skates to the river and strapped them on him, then trotted around after him on the ice so as to be on hand when he wanted. But he wasn't ever asked to try the skates himself. In summer, the pet pastime of the boys of Dawson's Landing was to steal apples, peaches, and melons from the farmers' fruit wagons, mainly on account of the risk they ran of getting their heads laid open with the butt of the farmer's whip. Tom was a distinguished adept at these thefts by proxy. Chambers did his stealing and got the peach stones, apple cores, and melon rinds for his share. Tom always made Chambers go in swimming with him and stay by him as a protection. When Tom had had enough, he would slip out and tie knots in Chambers' shirt, dip the knots in the water, and make them hard to undo, then dress himself and sit by and laugh while the naked shiverer tugged at the stubborn knots with his teeth. Tom did his humble comrade these various ill turns partly out of native viciousness and partly because he hated him for his superiorities of physique and pluck and for his manifold cleverness.